This is the Dell XPS from 2015. It was a flagship in its time. I got this laptop just last week for a friend who needed a very capable machine that is sleek, premium, and that won't cost money heist 5. What's up guys, it's Victor here again. In this very quick video, I'll be reviewing the XPS 13 from 2015 in 2020. A 5 years old machine that still looks good 5 years later. Is it worth buying in 2020? Is there a future for this guy? Can it actually serve as a workstation for high graphics intensive tasks like photo editing and gaming? What are the problems I will face if I buy this device? And finally, is it a bang for your buck? Now, before we get started, if you are new here and you haven't subscribed to the channel and you are interested in contents like this one, please do subscribe by hitting the subscribe button. Turn on the post notification bell icon so that you'll be notified the next time and every other time I post new and awesome videos like this one. Alright, 5 years later, the 2015 Dell XPS 13 still looks very relevant, with very thin bezels around the display. The device is gorgeous and shows all shades of silky premiumness. It is thin and compact, feels good to hold, and it is light at about 1.3 kilograms. Even in 2020, it still smells like a Christmas gift. The top and bottom of the device are covered by aluminium, while the inside and keyboard areas have a soft touch carbon fiber material. It's just a beautiful device. It comes with a 6th generation quad-core Intel Core i5 processor, which is obviously not the fastest i5 processor in today's world, but it is still very capable to tackle high-end computer tasks like video editing and rendering. It has 8GB of RAM and 256GB of flash solid-state memory, and it comes with 2GB NVIDIA dedicated graphics memory. This laptop is very fast and can actually manage to be a desktop replacement. I edited a video on Premiere Pro with no problems whatsoever, apps opened very quickly, and I had 4 high graphics apps opened and I was still feeling soft. I rendered the Premiere Pro clip and there was no smoke. For the power this guy packs and considering it's coming from 2015, I am actually a little perplexed why it is this sleek, slim and light. The screen is a 13.3 inches display, but when you look at it, it looks like a 12 inches laptop because the bezels around the screen are so thin. So the screen to body ratio is very high. This is a full HD display, but some 15 inches variant of this laptop has 4K and a touchscreen display. The display has an anti-glare matte finish that eliminates reflections. The keyboard is a full-size chiclet backlit keyboard, one of the best keyboard I've touched on the PC side of things. I just wish there is a little more key press travel. The touchpad is a glass integrated pad and it is buttery smooth. Apart from the touchpad on MacBooks, this is probably the best or one of the best out there. There is a webcam at the bottom of the screen, popularly known as nose cam. This placement for me isn't right because it looks directly on your nose and doesn't look great. It's not really a deal breaker, it's just a downside. For ports and IO, on the right side of the XPS 13 is the power button, USB Type-C and Thunderbolt port, USB 3.0 port for fast transfers, an earphone and microphone jack, and finally, there is a battery level indicator button. On the front side, there is just a LED indicator to show when the device is charging and when the battery is low. On the left side is a memory card slot and a USB 3 port. Under the device is a flap that covers the serial number and product markings, and 2 rubber strips that run across the laptop to raise it for ventilation. There is a speaker on both sides of the laptop and the sound isn't too fantastic but loud and clear enough. I used this computer for 2 days as my primary workstation and I was not frustrated. Boot time was fast, apps opened quickly, and I completed all my video and graphics work with no problem or hitch. The Dell XPS 13 from 2015 is still a valid offering, and I would totally recommend this to anyone that is into video or graphics and requires a very capable machine and color accurate display and is on a very lekpa budget. You will get this off eBay for around $550, which I think is a very good deal considering the relevance of this computer. The only issue you might face with buying a device this old is the battery, because it's an old machine, the battery has degraded so much that it doesn't hold power that much. After a full charge and after using this laptop for only 30 minutes editing videos, it dropped to 70%, but you can always get a battery replacement. Another thing to consider is that it gets hot while using it or while charging. But I've not overpowered this laptop to that level where it throttled. It didn't throttle throughout the time I used it. Okay, instead of buying a new popular and average laptop with a Pentium processor, a quad low res display and maybe 4GB of RAM, please buy a flagship like this one from before. it packs better value for money. So that's it, the 2015 Dell XPS 13, still a very capable, reliable, and relevant machine. Subscribe if you're not, like and share if this was helpful. Thank you for watching this one, and I will see you when I see you in the next one. Peace.